there, my name is Mike, and in this short sequence of videos, I'm going to be showing you how to lay the DuraTrack composite decking. In this particular instance, we're going to be using the Frontier range in the Aroco colour laid on the Manticore plastic lumber. This can all be found at EnviroBuild.com. So now I'm going to introduce some of the tools that we recommend to help you lay your DuraTrack composite decking. So starting with the power miter saw, this will help you cut down your deck boards to the appropriate size. We recommend that you use a 40 tooth blade. This will have nice accurate cuts and not make the deck board too worn whilst you are cutting. Also have some more simple tools like the impact driver, the spirit level and the tape measure, and more importantly, your personal protection equipment. So one of the most important factors of your substructure is to make sure that it's all level and correct. So for this balcony, to do that, we're going to use these recycled plastic supports. The great thing about these is they're easy to adjust the height simply by screwing counterclockwise to raise the level or clockwise to bring it back down. We also use these rubber mats, and these are great because you can pop them underneath the pedestal and it protects your roof membrane. So as you can see behind me, we've already laid out the pads at the appropriate centres, so now it's simply a case of placing the pedestals on top of the mats. If you have any tight corners, you can actually turn the pedestals upside down and they can be adjusted this way also. So in this instance, this is what we're going to do. And so once your pedestals are in place, we'll then lay the joists on top and then adjust the height accordingly. So as you can see, we've now laid out all of our pedestals in their appropriate positions. We've got them at 75 centres, as discussed before. You might also notice that we've got slightly more support pedestals in the foreground there. This is due to the arrangement of the joists, but this will be explained in a later video. So for this deck structure, we're going to be using Manticore plastic lumber, made from 100% recycled plastics. The great thing about this Manticore plastic lumber is that it won't rot like traditional timber, and also it's very easy to cut. So now we're going to attach the joist cradle to the plastic lumber using standard countersunk wood screws. So for this specific decking project, we're going to be laying the deck boards widthways, which gives the appearance of the deck being wider. So with that being said, it also means that the support joists will be running the length of the course. So currently, we have laid our first structural beams down. So these are the cross beams. So these contain also the joist hangers, which you saw before us attaching to the plastic lumber, and the joist will sit within the cradles. So as you can see now, we've got most of the substructure laid down with all of the joists sat within the joist hangers. One thing to bear in mind is to leave a slight expansion gap at the end of each of the joists of around about 5 to 6 millimeters. This is just to allow for any natural expansion of the joists. You'll also notice that in this center section here, we've got two joists. The reason for that is because when we lay the deck, this is going to be where the butt joints meet, and you'll require two clips to go on the joist, but that'll be explained later. Okay, so now you can see that we've obviously got the majority of the substructure down. So it's now a case of checking the levels of all of the pedestals to make sure that they're supporting the joists and that our deck is going to be level. So if you have a look at all of your pedestals and if you see that they are able to move around, they're obviously not supporting the joists at all. So they need to be raised up, tight against the foot of the joist, and then we check the levels. So now that the substructure is nice and level, we're going to start on the deck. So we're going to be using the DuraTrack composite decking, which is made of 90% recycled materials. So to start off the decking, we're going to install the first board into the DuraTrack starter fastener. This is to be installed onto the outside edge of the outer joist, as you can see just here. So now we're going to install the first board. So it's simply a case of getting your deck board, placing it down, sliding it up towards the first clips, and then with a bit of persuasion, a tap using your hand or a rubber mallet, make sure that the first deck pushed into the clips
and secured.
Slightly tilt it up. Fix the fastener in place. And then with a little bit of sideways pressure on the fixing, lightly screw down. So now that we've got all of our hidden fasteners on the joists, we're now ready to install our second row of boards. Now, as you can see here, we put a double joist. This is because this is where we're going to have our first butt joint. So we've already put this board in place. So I'm going to show you the easiest way to install the boards on the far side of the fasteners. So if you align it appropriately and then tip it up slightly, you'll find that it will slide nicely into the fastenings, and then with a bit of persuasion, it should fit into place. It's also important to realise that you need to leave an appropriate gap on the joints for the expansion, because these boards will expand, but they do expand lengthways. So it is important to leave a 6 to 8 mil gap on the butt joints. So now with the second row of boards in place, we'll now affix the second hidden fastener. This will secure the second board into place. With this in place, it now allows us to go back to the first set of fasteners to tighten them up to. Now we're going to look at installing the last two boards of our deck. But the first thing to consider is making sure that you get the measurements of your end clips correct first of all. So the way to do this is to measure the last two widths of the board and add a 6 mil gap, and that should give you your measurements from your third board to the end of your end clips. Now when it comes to installing, you put your end board in first in the same way that we put in the very first board of our deck, ensuring that the decking board is nicely butted up against the end clips. Then you take your second to last board and you tilt it backwards towards your third board and pop into place. And if you've got your measurements correct, you should find that your fastener is able to just slide into place, put it over your joist, So, to finish off the decking nicely, we've attached the fascia board to the joists. So we've pre-drilled the hole and countersunk, and then attached through the fascia board into the joist. So in this video, we're going to show you one of the great benefits of the Frontier range. So with a typical barbecue type spill of oil, grease or food stuff, you can see that it's easily wiped clean. All I've used here is just a standard napkin and a bit of elbow grease, and away it goes. So now, as you can see, we've finished our deck, we've put all of our furniture in place, and it's time to enjoy a nice drink in the evening.